Hello friends, welcome you all in 100 days of challenge to become DevOps and cloud expert. Today is day one, so we are going to set up the foundations. I just want your support and equal participation so we can make these sessions effectively. Next thing, we will learn together. So this challenge is not only for you, it's also for me. So I'll try my best to share my knowledge with you. Now let's talk about agenda for today's session. So after today's session, not only you will be able to simplify or define the DevOps, but also you will understand what is the life cycle, what are the key principles, how where exactly it is used in real world, and what are the OODA loop that is used by DevOps teams to define or taking decisions to solve any customer problem. So without wasting time, let's get started. Now let's define what is DevOps. If you will type what is DevOps on Google, you will see multiple sites who is defining this DevOps term. But there is one thing common in all the definition, that it is saying DevOps is a set of tools and practices which is helpful to shorten the life cycle of software development. This is the generic definition of DevOps, but now I am going to redefine it in my own way, that DevOps is all about collaboration, communication, development, continuous integration, automation, and adopting new culture, because these are the buzzwords which actually defines the DevOps. Now we can use these buzzwords anywhere where we are discussing about DevOps, either it is in interview, conference, or meetings. Now we'll see how DevOps teams takes the decision. Okay, so for this one, we are having this OODA loop. What is that OODA loop? It's a decision making cycle that can be used to improve the speed and agility of DevOps team. So this cycle actually having the four key steps. First O stands for observe. That means that we need to gather the information about the current state of the system. Next O stands for orient. It means that we need to analyze the information we gathered and identify the key problems from that. Next, we are having D stands for decide. That means we need to make decision about how to address the problem we found it. Okay. Last letter A stands for act. That means we need to implement the decision what we have taken in our previous step and monitor the result. So this is how DevOps teams use this decision making cycle to solve the problem of customers. Now let's talk about DevOps life cycle, which consists of several phases. Each phase contributes something for seamless software delivery. So let's start from the first phase, that is our plan. This step defines the project goals, scope, and requirement. Next phase is code, where developer write the code for our solutions. Next phase is build, where automation compiles code into executable forms. Next phase is test, where automated testing verifies code quality, functionality, and security. Also, it detects issues at early stage. After that, we have the phase called release, where we need to prepare code for the deployment, ensure that it's stable and meets release criteria. Sixth step is deploy. Automation deploys code to production environment with minimizing human errors. Next step is operate, where manage applications in production, ensuring stability, performance, and availability. And the last step is monitor, where continuous monitoring tracks application performance, user experience, and potential issues for swift response and improvement. So these are the life cycle stages where each application goes through for the betterment. So guys, let's talk about the key principles of DevOps. Why we need these key principles? Because it helps us to enhance efficiency, agility, and quality. So we are having certain key principles here. So the first key principle, we are having automation. Automation helps us to shorten the life cycle of software development. That's why it is very important. We tell that our definition itself of DevOps tells that DevOps is a set of tools and practices which help us to shorten the life cycle. With the help of automation, we can automate repeated tasks which we normally perform manually. Next principle is continuous delivery. Continuous delivery actually allows team to release software updates very quickly, safely, and frequently. So that's why we can release updated version very soon in the market itself or in the production, we can say. Next key principle is feedback loop. Our DevOps life cycle, or we can say the effective software with high quality depend on this key principle. Feedback loops provide teams with the opportunity to continuously refine their processes, learn from mistakes, and improve overall experience for customers. Next key principle is infrastructure as a code. Infrastructure as a code, that we can define our infrastructure in terms of coding templates, so we can reuse it, and whenever we need to deploy new infrastructure, we can use the same template, so it will be consistent without any error, because human error can happen any point of time, but we, if we will use any template, definitely we will get the identical system. The last key principle is shared responsibility. Yes, as we are in DevOps, we work with different teams, cross-functional teams. So the thing is, now the responsibility also shared. So shared responsibility is a core principle of DevOps that emphasizes the importance of collaboration and accountability across all teams which are involved in the software development lifecycle. Let's quickly see the benefits of DevOps, why we need to use it. The first benefit is faster deployment. Yes, DevOps enables you to release code into production more quickly, reducing the time it takes to get the latest features in front of the customer. Next advantage we are having, it provides improved quality, continuous integration and delivery helps to identify and fix issues before they reach into the production phase, that improve the quality of releases. Next advantage we are having, it provide enhanced collaboration. As you know, DevOps encourages cross-functional collaboration between development and operations team, and also promote greater efficiency and a more unified approach. Next benefit we are having, rapid problem resolution. Yes, having an environment where everyone collaborates and share information with each other, even they are belongs to different teams, that help in identifying and solving problems quickly. The next benefit we are having is scalability. Yes, with the help of cloud computing, yes, DevOps provide scalability. That means that it provide infrastructure as per demand whenever it is needed. If you want to reduce, you can do it. If you want to increase, you can do it quickly. No need to wait for more time. So these are the few benefits from DevOps. There are many, but we covered the most important ones here. Now it's time to go through some real world examples. So first example, we are having Netflix. As you all are using Netflix, right? You know that Netflix uses DevOps principle to offer seamless, reliable and scalable streaming services to millions of users worldwide. Next example we are having of Amazon. DevOps is one of the key factors contributing to Amazon's success in delivering products quickly and meeting customer needs. Next example we are having of Etsy. Etsy builds and updates features used by millions of sellers and buyers worldwide with their DevOps approach. Next example we are having of company Target. Target improved its website stability by adopting DevOps practices for faster delivery times and better efficiency. So these are the few real world examples I shown, but there are lots of, now most of the organizations are using DevOps. So this is the best time to learn DevOps. So guys, that's it we are having in day one session. Tomorrow join me or new concept where we will deep dive into the cloud computing fundamentals with real world examples. Until then, keep exploring, learning and transforming your world with the magic of DevOps and cloud. See you in next video tomorrow.